Hello, and welcome back to my playthrough of Dragon Quest III. And in this episode, I will be entering Baramos' lair slash castle in order to beat the big tough guy up. And with what I left you with the end of last episode, will this indeed be the end? Or is there a twist that will cause the game to continue? You will have to find out at the end of this episode. But until then, let's just crack on with it. Without further ado, it is time to go, and just so you know, these are all the stats. I've leveled up quite a bit. First, we've got the Thunder Sword, the Blade Armor, the Magic Shield, Ortega's Helmet, and Ruby Ring, and all of that lovely stuff. Spike has got the Four Staff, Angel Robe, Magic Shield, Silver Brick, Benevolent Ring. Benevolent Ring is very helpful. Aiden has got the Power Knuckle, Fight Suit, Black Hood, and Angry Tattoo. Can't have a shield, but that's fine. And then Jasmine's got the Zombie Killer, Magic Armor, Magic Shield, Horned Hat, and Hero Ring. So without further ado, it is time to get into it. Going to make a save state one as well. Anyway, there is a very sneaky way into the further parts of the castle, and I've completely cocked it up because it is literally just across here, and this is a shortcut. Cuts out a lot of crap. And now you do get some metaballs, which are obviously liquid metal slimes. Wait, no, this is going, that's the entrance to the donjon. I've messed this up, hang on, I don't remember. I did it a few months ago, but I don't remember the shortcut. And yeah, those idiots like using that. Because they like spamming. Yeah, go around here, this is where I want to go. And then into here. I remember now. Yeah, there's like, there's nothing to really find either. You know, it's just go through the dungeon, defeat big boy Baramos, and be on your way. See, there's nothing across there, it is literally just into here. I don't want too many battles because I want to make it through with as much MP as possible, and with these idiots especially, I will have to keep on healing up, especially when they use moves like that. Lovely. I don't remember what way I want to go. I think I want to go across to here. Not sure though. Is it this way? I don't remember. Stone Man. So if you get a crappy turn order, you know, it's not the best. Let's go this way instead. I guess I'll keep on going to the right from here. Yeah, I think this is definitely the right way. Yes, and then you go to the top. See those already open chests? Naughty, naughty. What do I go for? Do I go for enemies that can instantly kill, or go for enemies that hit like a truck? I think I'll go for enemies that hit like a truck. That's exactly what I thought. Aiden attacks, finishes it off. Of course, someone dies, because why not? Alright, came back to life straight away, so I'm fine with that. Anyway, I don't believe there's too much longer left of Big Boy Baramos' castle. Yeah, I don't think it's long now. You come up here, go back outside. Then boom. Yep, and then across to here. And in we go. Here he is. So as you can see, I've got a lot of stuff. So obviously heals all HP, as you know. And then Healus is the one that heals everybody. But yeah, not a very long dungeon at all. So you finally come, Phantom, but it is not yet time. You are not yet strong enough to defeat Baramos. You'll regret coming here. I'm going to feast on your innards. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Do do do. So I'm gonna buy kill Phantom. Attack with Aiden. I'm gonna speed up. Bang. Bing, 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 bing. He's gonna mostly use magic, so there's no point messing around. So now them two have been healed up nicely, buffed up. Not going to use be dragon. It's all enemy group. I don't want enemy group. Screw it. Okay, then I'll do it. See, a very menacing music for Baramos. Well, as I should say, Big Boy Baramos. Here he goes. Scorching breath. Magnificent damage. Attacking Phantom. He's not the wisest decision you've ever made, though, is it, mate? Nope. Everyone restore circa 80. That's pretty good. Ha! Do 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 do. Waste your time with stuff like chaos, yeah. Do 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 do. Bang. Bang. I don't know if I could zap him either, to be honest. I could zap him, but... I should try and zap him. There he goes, Big Boy Baramos. With the Big Boy decrease. Why would you attack Phantom? You're an absolute idiot. So yeah, Healor himself. And then she just goes for another Healus. Oh, big boy damage again. God damn. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Smack. Spike getting hit with a big boy damage. So she can heal all, and then she can do one more healus. There. you fool. Down you go. That's it, game done! Nah, I gotta go back to the castle yet. Damn you, Phantom! I'll never! Ugh. A warm light surrounds the area. The party's MP, HP and MP were fully restored. A voice comes from above. You did it. It's time for you to go home. Everybody's waiting for you. Here we are at Aliahan. Phantom, you've come back. You did it, Phantom. You've defeated Baramos. Hooray for Phantom. We can finally live in peace again. You've done a great job, Phantom. This is an item shop. Oh, you can still buy stuff. So, I mean, you can return to places. I'm not going to go back to the pirate hideout yet, but I know I have been told to go there. But you know, I can go to Aliahan Castle first, because it doesn't end the game at that point. Anyway, I've got 39. I mean, that's decent, but still, I could do with more. Off we go. You did well, Phantom. You truly are Ortega's son and are deserved to be called a hero. Now let us start the celebration. Yay, end of the game. Nothing else is totally going to happen. Oh, wait. What is going on? Oh, no! Looks like it's not the end of the game. Looks like it was a late 1980s troll from Square Enix. Make you think you win the game, but you don't. I mean, when the original came out in 88, this is pretty good. But anyway. Wahaha! It seems like I've interrupted your joyous moment. I am Zoma, the ruler of the Dark World. So there he is. He's very annoying in the legacy extras in Dragon Quest IX. Soon, this world too will become wrapped in darkness. It's time to see you all suffer. Your suffering brings me joy. All living beings shall be demolished by me, as the entire world sinks deeper into despair. I am the bringer of destruction to all things. I'm looking forward to the day we meet, so I can kill you as well. And an earthquake. No, this can't be. Finally, we thought peace had finally been restored to in our world. This must be kept secret. No one can find out about. Phantom, you must go and defeat Zoma. So go now without hesitation. The true final boss. And this whole stuff with Zoma is what is going to connect the game to Dragon Quest 1. And you'll see why. But anyway, before I go to a certain place, I want to go back to the pirate hideout. Look at how big Ramier is. It's a big bird. I was told to return once Big Boy Baramos was killed. I remembered this time, I forgot when I did it originally. She might give me something, I don't know. Sorry? The pirates return here at night. You seem to be pretty strong. There it is. Did some rearranging. No, the echo flute is not going to do anything now. Anyway. They return at night now. Oh, how things have changed. You've defeated Baramos. Women always triumph over men. The right tactic is the key. Even if I'm overpowered, there's always another way to win. What's that, Phantom? You're a man? Don't rely on your achievements. Bloody hell. Calling Erdrick a woman. Not a good idea. Or is it Erdwin? I never remember which one of the two it is. Anyway, I mean, it doesn't matter whether I enter the Dark World day or night, because it's constantly night. Anyway, have you guessed where I'm going yet? When I tried to trick you, I did kind of, well, I kind of hinted, give you subtle hints, but I sarcastically said that Gaia's navel is some pointless area. But now, thanks to the earthquake, I can enter this lovely, jubbly place and see what's up. So let's go. Look at the mist around it now as well. Something terrible has happened. An earthquake has split the earth and my partner fell into the hole. Oh dear. Here we go. Now I'm going to have some explaining to do when I talk to the man here, but I will explain it, don't you worry. I will explain it because this place is very important for the Dragon Quest franchise. Visitors again, you must have come from near world above. Welcome to Alefgard, the world of darkness. Now, for those of you that haven't played or seen anything on Dragon Quest 1, Alefgard is the name of the world. The layout is pretty much the same in this as it is in 1. You do the same type of stuff. The things you find are roughly in the same place. And you can and it's quite clever because you see, especially with some items, you get like the Sun Crest and basically this stuff to make a rainbow bridge, but you see how the items got to where they did in 1, and it's pretty clever. And, well, in Dragon Quest 1, Alefgard is not shrouded in darkness, so this helps explain how Alefgard became what it was. So, yes, there isn't too much to this world, but it is still a decent chunk for the game. But, yes, there we go. Alefgard was originally just known as the World of Darkness. Ludatorm Castle is to the east of here. My papa says that you can use our ship. So the objective is the same as Dragon Quest 1. I want to get the Sun Crest and the Rain Staff in order to make a Rainbow Bridge. And I also need a medal. You just saw the Zoma's castle down there. And I need a medal that will allow me to get into the castle. But you know. Do 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 do. So yeah, this music is basically the Dragon Quest 1 theme. Do 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 do. Like, there's a thing you have to find known as the fairy flute, which allows you to wake up a sleeping golem in the first one, but you use it for a different reason in this. But you know, do 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 do. Do 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 do. So basically, I'm going to be able to do whatever I want in this world. I just choose. Hang on, can I get anything at all? Yeah. So the whole world is going to be free for me to explore. I just choose what on earth I do. It's a good idea to talk to NPCs. Because I've played one, I knew where to find the fairy flute, which is needed. Very important. I knew of all the secret areas into places. And you had to find those secrets in original as well. I'm stuffed. My belly feels like it's about to burst. Yeah, anyway. And yeah, it's... It pays homage to the first one, and, you know, as I said, it explains how everything became what it was in one, and how, as I said, each key item that you get in Dragon Quest 1 was obtained by Erdrick here, and I'm guessing Erdwin is just from the same bloodline as Erdrick years later. Boo, 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 boo. Yep. I'm not going to use the wimpy book. Doo, doo. When rain and sunlight come together, a rainbow bridge will appear, or so the story goes. So, yeah, as I said, you need the Sun Crest and the Rain Staff. The Sun Crest you get from here. I mean, you can get both of them pretty quickly, but you need to get the medallion from the area where you get the, fairy flute, because you need to awaken something with the flute. Not a golem. But if you go to the town where the golem guards, you find this scientist who's like, oh, I'm thinking of creating a guardian for this town, I'm going to call him Golem. So that's a nice little reference. But I'll point out all the references, and, well, I'll probably be playing one anyway. And if I don't manage to finish Dragon Quest 4 before I do this, or what, by the time I finish this, I will do Dragon Quest 1, which won't take long. It'll only take a few episodes, but you know, still, anyway. So this town was originally where you got the Sun Crest, but I'm going to show you exactly how you get the Sun Crest. But first, actually no, I'm going to go up here. So this is where you start in Dragon Quest 1. So you want to talk to him. You came from the world above. I'm this country's king, King Lars. You might have already heard about me. Unfortunately, I can't rid my country of this current state of despair. Is there anything that you can do to help us? There's a lot I can do, my friend. Don't you worry. Because I will be saving you. So you want to talk to these NPCs. If you're going on a trip, then please allow me to sing you a song for your departure. From distant shores, far away, came the hero whose name is Phantom. Rumour has it that the fairy's flute is in the village of Cole. And it is in one. I'm the one who cared for Ortega. He had terrible burns and collapsed outside of the castle. He continually had trouble remembering things until finally he could recollect only his name. So Ortega himself managed to make it to here. The village of Cole is to the east of here. If you have a ship, then you'd better use the Western Sea and go around continent via the southern route. This is the Chamber of King Lars. No crap, my friend. No crap. Hang on. No. I'll be getting the map for Alefgard across here, because otherwise when you press R it just says, oh, it appears you're not on the world map. What? You came here from the world above to defeat Zoma? You're not from around here, are you? Then surely you will get lost here. So allow me to help you here. Please take this. It's a map to help keep you from getting lost. So. It's not too big. But you can see Zoma's castle in the middle. It looks like there's ways to get through via a ship, but there isn't. All them bits are blocked off, and plus you do not get a ship in Dragon Quest 1. There is no ship. You have to go by foot, and there's only one way to save, but anyway. Here are the three items, or, well, equipment and weapons that you could want to get. Zoma stole and hid the weapons and armor from this castle. So you've got the light shield, the light sword, and the light armor. He must have feared them, or else he wouldn't have wasted his time, so yeah. A bit like Dragon Quest V with all those arms that, you know, were very useful. There was a time when many people used to stay here, but now we don't get any customers at all. So there's the partner of the one at Gaia's Navel. Oh, look at that, a Pachisi ticket. So I believe it's in the village of Cole when you get it. But yeah, I think there's four dungeons altogether, not counting Zoma's castle. You've got a cave, which is important, and you get a key item from. You get a tower where you use the fairy flute. You've got another short cave where you just collect items in it. And then you are. I've heard that Rubis created this country. However, Zoma apparently has sealed Rubis away with a curse. And that's where you use the fairy's flute. This is the kitchen. Now, the sun crest was the last key item I got, because it's here. But all I had to do was do this. You see, I actually rubbed against this wall. And I was like, oh, went in the middle. And then found it. Very unlucky, to be fair, but, you know. She had the light orb you used to weaken Zoma during his fight. And that's similar to the Kalasmos battle in Dragon Quest XI. It's also got the same thing anyway. Oh, no, it's not Suncrest, it's Sunstone. But now I've got the Rain Staff to get. And the medallion from Rubis, but I've got to save her first. The thought of even defeating Zoma seems unreal, but if you obtain the King Sword, Armor of Light, and the Hero Shield, you might actually have a shot. They all used to be located in this castle, until Zoma got rid of them, because he is a salty bitch. So this is where you originally found the Sunstone, in Dragon Quest 1. However, I'm going to explain what you do once you defeat Zoma. The Sunstone, there's nothing like that here, but it's odd. I had a dream that someone gave me such a stone when the darkness faded. So, he is who you get the sunstone off of. And you need to get the magic key so you can open up the doors to get back and around here. So, it's quite clever because one in the end of the game, you can give him the sunstone. And that sets up how he gets it in one, which is pretty clever. But you know, I want to heal up before I leave. So yeah, that's going to be it for this episode. And I can start properly going through Alefgard tomorrow. But anyway, that marks the end of this episode of my playthrough of Dragon Quest 3. And in the next episode, I will be going through Alethgard by... I think I'll be clearing out the western side of the map first. Now, there are a few different items and key items scattered across. As I said, the King's Sword, the Light Shield, etc., etc., are all just scattered everywhere across the map, as well as the key items. Like the Rain Staff, I'll be getting from a pool of poison, and there's a shrine in the middle, and I'm told about Rubis. As I said, the Village of Coal will get me to the Fairy Flute. And you see those little... Hang on, let me press that. The little cluster of islands in the top of the map. One of them is where you have the tower that locates Rubis. And as I said, once I do that, I get the crest. Once I've got the crest, the sunstone, and the rainstaff, combine them together, make the rainbow bridge across into Zoma's castle, and then go beat the bitch. But of course, you know, I have to run errands for all the different towns and just collect stuff as much as possible. And I will say, the three items, the King's Sword and the armour, is indeed from Dragon Quest 1, because you can collect Erdrick's armour. It's called Erdrick's Sword in that, and I believe his helm. But yeah, as I said, I will stop rabbiting, and I will see you in tomorrow's episode when I do start the Alethgard section properly. But until then, with a massive thumbs up, all I've got to say to you now is goodbye and good night.